Greetings to everyone out there, to those of you who are watching from any part of the world. I welcome you to another section on economics, learning of economics. I welcome everyone to this section. I would like you to take your time or the opportunity to subscribe to our channel as we go on for today's studies or today's session. Yeah. Before I start today with the disadvantages of the exchange rate systems that we have in a particularly free floating exchange rate system, I would like to go over some of the things that we did in our previous session, which is the different types of exchange rate systems that we have. We agreed that there are four different types of exchange rate systems, and one of them is a free floating exchange rate system. We also have the fixed exchange rate system. We have the pegged exchange rate system, and then we also have the managed exchange rate system. Now, we've explained that the free floating exchange rate system is a system where the government does not intervene in the market, but then the exchange rate is determined by demand and supply in the market. The market is allowed to act and behave on its own without any form of a policy or governmental interference. That is what we call free floating exchange rate system. We equally look at the advantages of free floating exchange rate system, where we said one of them is that there are no opportunities for speculations to profit at the expense of the country because of the demand and supply that controls the market. It's very difficult for people to speculate and thus benefit or make profit from the system. Now, another one we also said is that demand and supply for domestic currency will be balanced in the market simply because the market forces are the ones that determines the exchange rate without any form of a pressure or interventions from anyone. Yeah. With that little ado, I would like to look at the disadvantages of a free floating exchange rate system, which we did not do in our previous session. So I would like to take it as it is on the PowerPoint, and then I will discuss them. Now, disadvantages of a free floating exchange rate system. Now, high nominal and real exchange rate volatility may distort resource allocation, as many resources will be devoted to hedging the exposure of exchange rate fluctuations. Now, the other one is further, the future part of the exchange rate will be uncertain, which may create difficulties for businesses in planning and pricing, and the freedom to operate an independent domestic monetary policy may be abused when, for instance, the government not being compelled to prevent exchange rate depreciation may be tempted into inflationary budgetary and monetary policy. Now, another one, or to continue with the disadvantages, we also say, in addition, there is a chance of overshooting, which will result in the exchange rate settling at a level not warranted by the country's financial positions, perhaps for a considerable period of time. You know, so due to the system that the market forces are the ones that determines what the changes in the market without any governmental interferences, there are high chances that there will be what? There will be distortions in the market. There will be problems with what? Nominal and real exchange rate of volatility, the fluctuations in exchange rate, you know, because this is not being controlled, it's free, and then the market system is what determines all this. Now, not to waste much time on this particular one. I would like to move on to Okay, with that much ado, I would like us to look at the fixed exchange rate system. We've already discussed free floating exchange rate system. So we'd like to move on to the second one, which is a fixed exchange rate system. Now, what is a fixed exchange rate system? Just like the name itself sounds, fixed exchange rate system. It's a system whereby, you know, the currency of a particular country is it's fixed. It's I don't know the right word to use, but it's fixed to the extent that it's a fixed exchange rate. It's a system in which the exchange rate of a currency is not determined by the market. It's not determined by the what demand and supply. Instead, it is determined by the central bank. So the government generally fixes the currency or fixes the exchange rate of their country against other countries. Now, there are likelihoods that that exchange rate could be fixed against a particular country or a group of currencies. Let's take, for instance, the exchange rate can be fixed against the US dollar, and then or alternatively it can also be fixed against a group of currencies, let's say the euro, the dollar, the yuan, you know. So if we talk about fixed exchange rates, that's what it is about. I would like to take what is here on the slide so that we can all follow it and discuss it together. Fixed exchange rate. A fixed exchange rate is a system in which the exchange rate of a currency is not determined by the market. Instead, it is determined by the central bank. The exchange rate of this currency can be fixed in various ways. However, a fixed exchange rate is a conservative system that is generally used by conservative countries such as China. You know, for instance, the exchange rate of one currency, that is the Chinese yuan, could be fixed in relation to another currency, such as the United States dollar. Alternatively, the exchange rate of one currency could be fixed in relation to a basket of currencies, such as the euro, the dollar. The euro, the dollar, or the yen, you know. Lastly, the exchange rate of one currency could be fixed in relation to the price of a precious metal such as gold. Now, this is where the range of the peg is updated from time to time based on factors such as Once the exchange rate is fixed, it is the job of the central bank to ensure that the price changes in the underlying currency closely mirror the price changes in the target with a small margin for error. Now, the expected error should be plus 1 or minus 1%. In practice, countries do not really have absolute peg. Maintaining an absolute peg is very difficult from an operational point of view. Instead, these countries choose a range that has an upper and a lower limit. If the value of the currency fluctuates within this limit, then the central bank takes no action. However, as soon as the limit is breached, the central bank takes swift action. This range could be very small, that is 2%. On either side of it could be as large as 75% on either side. Also, the range may may or may not be disclosed to the general public. An absolute peg is difficult to maintain since it becomes absolute over time. It is for this reason that many countries follow the crawling peg system. So with this, I believe by now, we've all understood the concept that I've explained earlier on that has to do with a fixed exchange rate system. We said fixed exchange rate system is a system whereby the central bank determines a particular or a fixed amount of exchange rate. Now, I earlier on also mentioned very well that this currency could be fixed against a particular currency, or it could be fixed against a group of currencies. Now, it has also been discussed that this currency it has to be pegged within a particular limit, a particular percentage. Now, if the exchange rate varies and then nothing is done, let me say the exchange rate varies, however, it falls within the pegged percentage, then the government does nothing. There is no need for panic. There is no fear for any adjustment, you know. But then if it exceeds or go beyond the pegged percentage, then the government will swiftly go into action to do something in other to hedge against that increase in the exchange rate. All right. So in our next discussion, I'm going to bring you some of the advantages and disadvantages of a fixed exchange rate system, and the disadvantages as well. After which, we would move on to the other types of exchange rate system. With this much ado, I thank you for watching. I thank you for your time. I thank you for for following this video to the end. If there is any questions, any discussions, you may put it at the comment sections, and I will attend to it with time. Please, you are allowed to air your views, but please do it respectfully, and let's keep this channel moving so I'll be able to bring more videos to those who are interested in economics and those who want more information on economics. Thank you for watching. Till our next session, I wish you all the best.